Hi friends, Miggi from Figma here. Today we're going to make some prototype animations using some new features available in Figma Draw. So let's go. What we're going to do is we're going to create this rotating cloud effect on our typography. The three concepts that we're going to cover today: creating a brush, using progressive blur, and using texture, as well as applying them as a prototype. I'm going to begin by pasting in some text. So I have this Figma Draw text. It's currently set in a large hepta slab. I'm going to press the F key. I'm going to draw out a frame. I'm going to make my frame 1280 by 1280 to start. I think that looks pretty good. Now I'm going to select this text. This text that we have here, it's currently editable. I am going to right click. I'm going to outline the stroke. You're going to see all of the vectors apply there. Next, set this up as union and then flatten that out. The shortcut key for flatten is going to be Option Shift F. There we go. Flatten, Option Shift F. Happy with it. We're going to go to Figma Draw. Now that I've selected this, I want to create this text as a brush. Now that this has been flattened, I'm going to right click. We're going to go to create brush. We're going to choose stretch brush. Now that that brush has been created, when we go down here and we choose the brush, we're going to see this union. If we want to rename it, we can edit brush. We can rename that brush and we can call it whatever we want. I'm going to call this the Figma Draw Text Brush. You can see the previous one that I made the last time I made this demo. There we go. That's amazing. Now, when I draw with it, that's the wrong brush. That's okay. We're going to come down here. Now, when I draw with it, you're going to see the text show up. The reason that this is going to be helpful is we're going to take that brush and apply it to a circle. I'm going to go ahead, draw that circle. Let's align it there in the center. Here, I'm going to add a new stroke. We're going to go right to brush stroke. We're going to add some thickness and we're going to select the brush we just created. You can see here as I add thickness and as I decrease the size of it, how that text stroke is being applied. We can remove the fill and now we have the text to begin our little creation here. Let's open that up just a smidge. That looks great. Now, the next thing we're going to do, we're going to select that text. We have that layer selected. You can see it over here. Inside of that, we're going to choose effects. We're going to first choose layer blur. Inside of layer blur, we're going to choose progressive. We're going to make the end result kind of exaggerated. Let's go about a value of 60. I'm going to move that start point and let's choose that endpoint. Let's move that endpoint up and that start point. I think that's pretty good. Now come over here to the effects panel. We're going to click that little drop down. We're going to choose texture. This time we're going to increase that texture. We're going to increase the size. You're going to see that it's applied to everything. We only want it applied to the blur area. When we choose clip to shape, you will see that it is in fact only applied to that blur area. As we adjust the size, you can see how that's affected there. Choose the values that you like the most. I think I am feeling this right about now. That's looking pretty good. The next thing that we're going to do, select the frame. We're going to press Command D or Control D if you're on Windows. D, D, D. There we go. So we have it four times. Let's select in the second frame. We're going to choose layer. We're going to move that layer over to the right. I'm holding the Shift key as I'm doing it to keep that angle. I'm going to select this one. Right? This is the third frame in the series. We're going to go to the progressive blur. We're going to move that down. Now, go to the last frame. Select the object. Go to layer blur and do the same thing for the fourth time. We're going to move it back up to the right. There we go. Starting at the top, then goes to the left, then goes to the bottom, then goes to the right. If you want to prototype this, we're going to go back to design mode. We can choose prototype mode there. If these are a little bit too tight for creating your noodles, you can go back to the design panel, select all of those layers, increase the spacing between them. Now go back to prototype. We're going to select this first frame. We're going to draw a noodle, right? See, I'm selecting the frame name, drawing a noodle, and then selecting that frame name and drawing a noodle. I'm going to click, drag, select only the noodles. Now that they've been selected, we don't want on click. We want to set after delay. The delay is going to be 1 millisecond. I tried to type in 0, but 1 millisecond makes more sense because there is no infinitesimal 0. time, space would collapse upon itself if we were to type in and that value were to actually work. The action is navigate to the destinations mixed because we're modifying multiple frames. We're going to choose Smart Animate as that option. We're going to choose the curve for this to be linear. This is one of those rare instances where linear makes total sense because it's going to be in constant motion. It's not going to be starting and stopping. We're going to go all the way around that circle constantly. We're going to set that duration to be about 800 milliseconds because this is going to be so large. We want to increase the time in between the frames so we can see all of those details taking place. Now that that has been set, let's give it a quick preview. Let's see what it looks like. That's looking pretty good. Okay, we're seeing the transition. We see it go. It looks kind of cool. We got some texture in there. Now, for the last little bit, what we're going to do is we're going to apply some colors here. I'm going to choose that first frame, go over to the design panel, select that fill. Let's go red for the background, and for the foreground, let's choose yellow. For frame two, we are going to select the background. Let's go blue. There we go. And now for the text on top, let's go a little bit lighter. Let's go lighter blue. Ooh, I like the way that looks. For frame three, we are going to select the background color. We are going to go fuchsia. And for the selection color on top, let's pick like a nice light green. It looks a little minty to me. I'm totally down with that. Now here for the fill on the last one, let's pick a color. Let's go full on green and change up that text to be, maybe we go, yeah, let's just go white. We're going to just try that out. See how that looks. I'm happy with that. Let's select that first frame. We're going to press shift space bar to preview it. We now have the rotating filter being applied to our text with this cool effect. Hopefully you have some fun with this. Maybe there's some practical applications that you can find for it. Currently, I just think it's a lot of fun and to do some explorations and see what can be done to help inspire and encourage new ideas. I hope you found this helpful. And as always, happy designing.